guys, welcome back. And today I'm going to be doing an unboxing of the Fitbit Versa. Now, I have been wearing activity trackers or activity bands for a while now. I have had two Jawbone apps, the version 2 and the version 3. The version 2 didn't last me 6 months. It actually broke. The bracelet broke off, and then the up 3 now is not working anymore. It doesn't want to sync to my phone or anything like that, and it doesn't charge. And both of them, one didn't last me 6 months, the other one didn't last me a year. So I was like really frustrated with that. And I thought, before that I owned the Withings activity tracker, and that's the one that had that had a clip that you can attach to your clothing or a band that you can wear. So I was using that before I bought the Jawbones. None of them worked particularly well for me. The Withings one was more, it had a heart rate monitor, a pedometer, and a sleep tracker. And that lasted me a while until I actually lost it. I don't know where it went. I think I might have slipped it in my jeans one time and it fell out. So anyways, long story short, I decided to get the Fitbit Versa. I was contemplating on which one to get. And this is the newest one that came out, and it looks very much like an Apple Watch. And the reason why I got this is, even though I've got like 3 watches that I alternate with, I thought that it would be good for me to have one of these for when I go to the gym, which I intend to start doing again from tomorrow. Now, the Fitbit Versa, I'll just tell you what are some of the things that it claims. So it automatically tracks activity, exercise, and sleep. It's got on-screen coaching, so because of the LCD screen, you can actually play short videos coaching you on how to perform certain exercises. It's got continuous heart rate monitoring, 15 exercise modes, and connected GPS. Some of the bands that I've used in the past are able to track your running or your walking, how many steps you're taking, but I'm not able to do any more exercises like biking, swimming, or reps at the gym. So I thought that this was going to be a good one. It has connected GPS. Now, if you want a built-in GPS, then the Ioniq would probably be a better one for you, but it is $100 more. This one is $299 here in Australia or $199 in the States. I don't know why it's much more expensive here. I mean, even if you did the conversion, it wouldn't have cost that much. But anyway, I digress. Now, connected GPS means that if you want to be able to track your route, you're still going to have to bring your phone with you. But I'm somebody who goes to the gym instead of running outside, especially during the winter where you can't predict if it's going to rain or not. So I thought, this is okay with me. Plus, the Ioniq looks quite masculine in my opinion, so I preferred something sleeker. You could definitely change the bands in this as well, which I've already ordered. I've ordered a metallic mesh that's got a magnet as a closure. Okay, it stores and plays up to 300 songs, but you have to connect it to your computer to be able to download the songs. It's not something that syncs with your Spotify or with your Apple iTunes. Okay, wallet-free payments. This particular model does not have that. There is a special edition one that has got the NFC chip inside where you can do payments. I don't really use my phone, or I won't be using this for making payments. Sometimes I'm even reluctant to tap my card for payments. I would prefer to actually have cash on hand so that I can see the money coming in and out of my hands and I can control my spending better that way. You are able to get call, text, calendar, and app alerts, but you are not able to answer the phone call using this. You're not able to text back. It's just really alerts. Okay, interchangeable bands sold separately. It claims to have 4+ days battery life, but most of the reviews that I have seen actually says more like 3 days, which is still better than the Apple Watch, because I think those you have to charge every night. Water resistant up to 50 meters, so you can take it into the shower, you can swim with it. That's absolutely fine. Durable, lightweight design. Yeah, so I got this from Rebel. I actually ordered it online. Rebel Sports now has Afterpay, so if you are reluctant to pay $300 Australian in one go, you can actually pay an installment, up to 4 installments. So that's what I did. And another thing that I did, because I ordered this online, I went through ShopBack, which is an app for cashback, and that gave me 5% cashback. So I'm actually getting $14.95 back from purchasing this through that. So enough with the blab. Let's have a look and open this baby up. So it comes in this box. It's got a slide. You open it. Fancy little thing. And here's the watch. I ordered the gray one. Actually, I ordered the peach and rose gold one, but it was too peach for me, honestly. And because the second band that I ordered isn't gonna come until the mid of May, in 2 weeks time, I didn't wanna wear a peach watch at work. So I actually exchanged it in store for the aluminum and gray one. So that's what it looks like while just out of the box. And I'm thinking that it's gonna match well with my wedding ring and my engagement ring, which are white gold. So there you go. So that's what it looks like inside the box. So it's got its container there. It's got some literature, like your how to use. Then you've got your charger, which is a little bit bulky, to be honest. It's not one of those things that you just attach a USB to. You actually have to, it's got a dock in there that you need to use. So you're gonna lay flat that watch into that dock, and then the end is a USB port that you can use with pretty much any of your adapters. And it's got an extra band. So if this is the large band, the one that's currently installed in mine is the small band, which is 5.5 to 7.6 in length. And this one I think is 5.9 to 8.5, I think. I'm not absolutely sure about that. But yeah, just in case you have larger wrist, I don't. So this is probably going to be a good option for me. That is what is inside the box. Now, the instructions in linking it to your phone, because I've already downloaded the Fitbit app. And you're supposed to dock this onto the charger and keep it docked when you are setting it up. And then you just follow the instructions on the phone. Now, these have a charge on them already, but you might want to charge them in full before you actually use it. So that's what I'm going to do tonight. I will be using this for the next couple of weeks. I'll be coming back to the gym by tomorrow. So I will let you know how it fares and if it's something that I would recommend. We'll probably give you an update on this in 1 month's time to see just how well it tracks my sleep, my activity, how accurate it is in terms of my steps. Now, this, like I said, this doesn't have GPS, so it will rely on your input of your height, your weight, and sort of estimate your stride depending on that. As a female with a certain height. So that's what it's going to do. If it's connected to your phone's GPS, that's the time that it will be able to track your route, your elevation, and stuff like that. Alrighty. That is all for the unboxing today. And like I said, there will be a follow-up video maybe in a month's time, at the end of May, to let you know if I am enjoying it. Now, if you guys are using wearables like this or activity trackers, let me know which ones you are currently using and how you are enjoying them and how long they've lasted you. Because for some reason, I find that these things don't really last well on me. At least the ones that I've owned previously. Hopefully this one will last. Oh, one other thing that I really liked about this is it's not available yet, but it's meant to come in May. There is female health tracking on here, where you'd be able to track your period. I'm not sure if you can track your ovulation as well, but definitely something to sort of remind you when it's safe and when it's not. Okay, so there you go. Like I said, if you are wearing wearables, let me know which ones you own and why you chose that particular one. And if you are currently not but are thinking of getting one, which ones are you like thinking about? All right, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Click on that notification bell so that you know when I upload videos. I do so about 3 times a week. And that's it. Bye.